Stay with you. Let me send an email out. Okay, we're gonna let a few more people get on here. So how was everybody's holiday? Did you enjoy it? Did you enjoy it so much you wanted to take an extra day today? Miss Calicut, I seen you went to Carolina. So how did you like it down there? Are you going to go to Carolina when you graduate? Is that going to be your college when you graduate? Yeah, I like Carolina. I've been there a couple of times. So are you going to go to school there when you once you graduate? Hey, Shamil. Hey, Austin. Hey, Elena. Hey, Andrew. Hey, Jonathan.
Hey, Audrey.
You doing okay today?
Yeah, man.
You just tired. I know.
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Hey, Austin. Hey, Michelle. Hey, Chanel. So y'all know I'll go back and look at everything. So how does everybody like now? You know, originally when we were face to face, we were a 5-day. And I always said we only needed to go to school 4 days a week. I've always said that. So now that we had an extra day, you guys get 3 days. I still have 4 days, but you guys get 3 days. So how many of you would like a 3-day week? That is the question for today. Who would like a 3-day week? Is there anybody like a 3-day week? Not sure. I think I'm okay with coming in on Tuesdays. I think, and I've always said that we could go 4 days a week. We can either go Tuesday through Friday, hey Felix, or we can go like Monday through Thursday. So I was really good with coming in today. Of course, I'm good with coming in every day, but you know, some days are just better than others. But I'm so glad you guys came to join me. And I think everybody probably still waking up. Me either, Andrew, I wouldn't mind it either. Jonathan, yes, I think it's pretty nice. I think coming in on Tuesdays, you're a little bit more refreshed. Although you guys should be kind of good because everybody's at home, so you're more relaxed and you don't have to get up and be putting on clothes. I mean, you know, not like if you were coming to school. So I think being at home has gave us a different perspective on life. And we'll have this experience, and some other generations won't have this experience. And then again, they may just only have experience of remote learning. Well, we had experience of both. I like interacting face-to-face, and I also like doing remote. I think right now we're still in the process stage, the early beginning stage, so we're learning things. So it looks like we have, hey, Danny, we're getting some more people on here. I'm going to give it about another 2 or 3 minutes, and then we'll go over what we need to go over. Was there anybody had any issues with the test? I think I had somebody to inquire about that. It only said, you know, they got a certain amount out of something. But I think hopefully if you go back into Power School, it should tell you what your grade, your final grade was. Because on this particular was our first test. It only had, I think, 12 questions. So hopefully, but if I notice, and if you let me know if things don't look like they calculate right, I'll go back and fix it, because right now we're having to change the things. So don't worry about that. But I think also, if you have not taken a test, make sure you take the test today, because I'm closing it out today. I think a little bit before midnight. So if you have not taken the test, please take the test. If you have not sent me, screenshotted me a copy of your study guide, or either send it through email via Google Docs, please get that done, because I count your study guides as a quiz grade. So make sure you are getting in your study guides. And let me put this in the chat. Okay, so I'm putting in the chat, please take your test. Everybody, if you are not aware, I have already told you that you have a test. It's in SchoolNet. I think I put the code in announcements. Please take your test before 11:30 tonight. Also, please send in your study guides. You can screenshot the picture of your whole completed study guide, send it, screenshot, upload it, send through email, send your study guide through Google Docs where you typed in the answers or whatever, because I count study guides as a quiz grade. So please make sure that you take that. Also, on Friday attendance, every Friday I send out a email, a mass email, that means to the whole class. And it's called Attendance Friday. Make sure that you are responding back to the email. And I did make a mistake on one person. I thought before that person emailed me, said, "Ms. Hargrave, you marked me absent." I thought I saw their name somewhere, but when I went back and typed it in, it didn't pull up anything. And sometimes that's just how things work with technology. But if you know that you responded back, let me know. But pretty much, I didn't even get, really, I'm on the side that probably didn't get 50%. So from now on, every Friday, I send out an email. You need to open up that email, read it, respond back to it. If it says type in this code, if I give you a code, that means you need to retype that code, send it back to me in an email reply. If it asks you one or two questions, please answer those questions. That is your attendance on Fridays. If I don't receive it back, you will receive an absence for that day. So please make sure that you're responding back to, you are not required to come to class unless, I've told you in the past, unless you haven't completed assignments or you need some extra one-on-one with me. But you are still required to check in on Fridays. So please make sure you do it. Everybody got it? Can I get a yes? Yes, ma'am. I got it. All right. So what I, thank you, John. Thank you. I have to do the thank you. I mean, I'm not trying to be hard, but they require us to do it. So You know, I'm sending out, but I'm not getting a whole lot of replies back. I know it's Friday, but you just can't completely check out on Fridays. Come on now. Let's just do a recap of what we did last week, and then I'm gonna let you go do your assignments today. So just bear with me as I try to. Hold on, y'all. So I hope everything's going well with your other classes. Is everybody staying on top of their work? And if you're having any trouble, please let your teachers know. Don't wait till the last minute. That's what we're here for. We're here to help our students. So go to your teacher, say, I'm having trouble with this. You know, if you haven't done an assignment, let them know and say, you know, I had some issues. Don't just not do the assignment, okay? So please, some of you, you know, I had some emails and it's like, well, I know I was late and I just didn't turn. I said, no, you turn that assignment in, okay? Because we know that this remote learning is still a work in progress. And hold on, let's see what's going on with my PowerPoint that I wanted to show y'all. Hold up, I think I'm gonna switch to another computer real quick, so if y'all will give me a minute, I'm gonna see what's going on. Hold up. I have 3 computers running. It looks like we're having technology issues on a Monday, and it is Tuesday. So bear with me, I'm coming back with you. I'm gonna join from another computer, so let me log out. Let me just call you. I'm coming back with y'all. Let me turn this on. Okay, guys, we're gonna try this again. Let me get to where I need to be. Hopefully. Nope. Still not what I want. Okay. So on last week, I just want to go recap real quickly. Okay. So last week, we did, I want to recap what stood out. Just go over some things. Let me see. I'm new at this. Okay. So recap what stood out. Last week, we learned about sports marketing. We knew that the definition, sports marketing meant the planning, the execution, the conception, the pricing, promotion, and distribution of sports ideas, goods, and services to create exchanges that satisfy individual and organizational objectives. We also learned that intangible items are like an experience you can see and feel, participate in. Like going to a game, anything that you can feel, touch, experience. Perishable experience is a football game you play. Perishable means that it goes away. That means so once you play a football game, you never actually get that game back again. You may play more, but not that particular one. We learned that athletes make the game happen. Without the athletes, okay, it's just very bland. The facility or venues are like Time Warner Arena, which they probably now have changed to Spectrum, Lowe's Motor Speedway. We also learned that sporting goods are tangible manufactured products that make the game possible, like the equipment, the clothing, all the licensed merchandise. Anytime y'all guys get jerseys, jackets, hoodies, whatever, you want everything to be licensed. Because, you know, license means that it is legitimate, it is top of the line. But every now and then, I guess some people do get knockoff items but there's still some of the knockoff items you're paying just as much for. We also learned about personal training. Personal training is where you get ready to compete. You participate in exercise class at like the local health club. So personal training can be for athletes. It can be also for just the regular people, like some of us. But a lot of you in here, ladies and gentlemen, you are athletes, so y'all guys know about personal training and about being fit. We also learned that there's sports information out there for us to catch up on the latest sports, who's top dog, who's the losers. We view this by ESPN, Sports Illustrated, newspapers. Also, I wanted to recap about the categories of sports consumers. Now, you have unorganized participants. These are just regular people who walk in the woods, they're jogging, freedom from rules. We don't have any rules. We're just unorganized. We do whatever we want to do. Organized participants have rules, like the NCAA, MLB. There are certain things that you have to do. It's called a sanctioning body. If you violate any of these rules or regulations, then you will be penalized with either a fine or rejected from the game or taken out a few games or all of the above. We learned that amateurs are not paid to play. They're regulated on local, state, and national level. They do it for the fun. Professionals are paid, but they have set strict rules that they have to go by. They do it for fun, but this is also their lifestyle. It's their career. So they don't play around with their money. So that's what I wanted to go over, just do a recap of what we did last week to gear us up to what we are going to get into this week. So this week, and I think hopefully I can still see what I got going on. If you'll go under modules, make sure you always go into modules for your upcoming assignments, or if I say that it's in assignments, please go to assignments as well. I want to also recap, I think on last week, let me get to that if I can. Y'all just have to bear with me. Okay, on last week, We had vocabulary terms. Make sure that you are going back on those vocabulary terms. You are also utilizing Quizlet, Kahoot, to help you with your vocabulary terms. Also, you had a lab assignment. In 102, you had a lab assignment. If you use a lab resource, then you were able to do the lab assignment. If you have not done that, please make sure you get to that today, okay? Because going out Friday, all grades will be posted. So you have time now to get in all your work. Also, make sure that you are keeping up with your discussion responses, because I do count those. Again, you have your quiz vocabulary review. You have your quiz, your Kia vocabulary test review that I want you to go over. Also, on last week, you had an assignment with the growth of Michael Jordan's brand. If you open that assignment up, it told you what you need to do, where you need to go to get the information. Please make sure you have done that. Also, on last Thursday, I put it up for you to turn in your 101 to 102 study guide. Study guides, you can upload, screenshot it, upload it, send it to me via email, or you can download the form, type in your information, send it back like Google Docs or whatever. This week, and I probably have not published it, and I'm getting ready to do it now. Okay. Let me get to it. You'll see 103. So today you should be doing your discussion response. If you look at your discussion response, it says, if you were elected to organize a school charity event, that means you're going to be doing a charity event in school, what would be the charity organization, and what type of event or theme would you use? So that's meaning what type of event or theme or would you use to let everyone in your school be aware of the school charity. So please make sure that you're using complete sentences whenever possible. Just don't give me a one-liner. Give me a couple sentences. Give me something to work with. This is going to ask you a couple questions, so I should have these 6 to 9, sentences. So make sure that you're doing your discussion response for today. Also, make sure we're going to go into real quick. I'm gonna go over the PowerPoint. You're gonna be responsible for doing your guided notes. Your guided notes are on your own. You know, I give you guided notes. I'll give you until today is Tuesday. I'll give you until Thursday for those guided notes. And I'm being very lenient on that, because usually I require you to do your guided notes after I go over the PowerPoint. So I'm going to go back over. Can everybody see my screen? I think everybody can see my screen. I'm hoping that you can. I'm going to go over the PowerPoint because I want to introduce the 103 is acquire information about the sport event industry to aid in making career choices. I'm going to go over the PowerPoint. Tuesday said 9/7. That's right. I got the date wrong, Felix. I'll change it. But I think y'all can just go ahead and do it. It says 9/7, but it'll be okay. Let me see what I did with that, what I downloaded. Yeah, because I'm using this my MacBook, so I don't know anything about my MacBook yet. I'm getting there. All right. So we're going to go over 103 again. It's entitled Acquire Information About the Sport and Event Industry to Aid in Career Choices. We'll, by us viewing this and we're going over it, we'll be able to explain career opportunities in sport and event marketing. So there are different types of businesses that offer career in sports and event marketing. So teams, you have your college, you have your professional, you have your amateur. You have venues. Venues are dealing with coordinating events, getting events established or together. And you have your sales, getting people to come to the events. So you could be an event coordinator, a sales coordinator. There's all types of careers in sports and event marketing. We actually have somebody who works for the Charlotte Hornets who is a Lexington graduate. So she works in the marketing department. And we met her when we went to one of the games. Probably this year we will not get to attend one of the basketball games. But maybe in the near future we will. Also, you have your parks and recreation departments. You have people, I think there is a Lexington alumni who is over, was over Lexington Recreation and Parks, where they have different types of events to come in. Some are just a one-time thing. Some are reoccurring. So there's all different types of jobs. You can have a private business in the sports and event marketing. Hopefully soon we'll get some people to come and talk to us about being in business in the sport marketing industry. You have your sporting good industry like retail, sales. So we have our local, even though it's a hardware, but Lanier Hardware for many years and still, they are known for their sporting equipment. When I was growing up, that's where we went to even order our cheerleading uniforms or any kind of sports that you were participating in, you can go there and get it. So never underestimate your local stores and see what they have to offer. Also, you have technology like websites, the apps, the research. You got your media, news industry, event planning. You have hospitality, charities, convention, and visitors. You have public relations. You have marketing. And dealing with marketing, you got marketing and sales, marketing research, finding out what is the latest trend, what people are interested in. You have your marketing agents. You have your fitness industries. So being in the sport and event industry, there's all types of careers that you can go into, and some of you need to look into it as well. Now, to distinguish means to tell the difference between sport marketing and event marketing. Sport marketing is dealing with sports. It's the involvement of sports to develop, promote, distribute goods and or service, and to satisfy the needs and wants of customers. Now, when you have an entertainment marketing, it involves entertainment. That's when you develop, you promote, distribute goods, services to satisfy the needs and wants of customers. Entertainment marketing is more like doing concerts. So mostly I think of entertainment as concerts, different things dealing with music, dealing with art. Hey, everybody, let me do what I do, and I'm gonna cut it short because it's time for y'all to go. But hold on here, let me make sure I get everybody accounted for. I did not realize when I was just talking that the internet was out. Somebody came in and said the internet was down. So what I want y'all guys to do is go back and review the PowerPoint. We'll try to go back over it again tomorrow. Review the PowerPoint. Begin working on your guided notes for 1.03. Also, make sure you've done the discussion response for today. I think I made a mistake and put 9.7. It should be 9.8, but it's the same thing. Also, if you have not done your Michael Jordan assignment, please get that done. If you have not done your test, please make sure your test is completed before 11:30 tonight. Also, make sure you turn in your study guide, a screenshot it where you print it out, wrote it in, upload it, send to me via email, or you can download the one that I have and just type it up and send it back Google Docs. So I have received some of y'all's study guides, but make sure the study guides are in because the study guides count as a quiz grade. And give me a few more minutes. Let me make sure I got everything done here. Hugo, you in the place? Hugo, Shamil, Duran, hold on, because I didn't get it earlier. So just bear with me a moment. If I should happen to count you absent today and you know that you were in class, just shoot me an email. Matthew Witherspoon. Life is here. Caesar. Do I have Caesar? Caesar, you here? Life has left the meeting. Caesar is not here. Hold on. All right, I think I have everybody. Again, y'all know what to do. Just check your modules and go from there. And I will talk with you guys on tomorrow. Have a great Tuesday, everybody.